தெரியல நதர் தானி சுந்தர் தானி சாதார தானி நதர் தானி சுந்தர் தானி சாதார தானி আওয়াজ
Well, I decided to come back to Varanasi because I was born here and my roots are very deep in this place. The street I was born in, the temples that I visited with my mother, and even when I woke up, the whole sound that came, like Hara Hara Mahadev. A couple of years ago in a Shivaratri morning I composed Hara 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 Mahadeva Trishula Damaru Dhari Adinatha Chandravasa Maheshwara Tripurari. Every little thing, the ghats, the boat, the Ganges, the sound of Shahnai, the deep religious and spiritual atmosphere everywhere. It is so much, you know, within me that I had to come back.
Nadar dani sundar dani sadar ta dani
Nadar dani sundar dani sadar ta dani
Second part Nadar dani sundar dani sadar ta dani
Nadar dani
sundar dani sadar ta dani Start first, second rhythm pick up first, third rhythm
Together?
Total four.
Together.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Nadar dani sundar dani sadar ta dani
Well, I get inspired by any form of beauty, whether a person or nature or sound, but usually I found that when I hear some sort of tone or swara in any form, even a motor horn or birds, you know, like here in Hemangana, sometimes I hear the cuckoo birds, quail or papiya, piu kaha, piu kaha, piu kaha. I was born in 1920 in this house at Tilabhandeshwar. I spent my childhood here. This is the school I went to. My school was very close to my house.
Well, I had really very little to do with my father, Dr. Pandit Shyam Shankar. Unfortunately, because he was mostly away in the West. He was a very great scholar. And I was brought up by my mother, whom I loved very much. And she was bringing
me up along with my other three brothers, Rajendra, Devendra and Bhupendra. The third brother, he died when I was 8. All this time we were in Benares and it was with my mother and the brothers.
It was almost at the young age of 10 that I went to Paris with my brother Dada Uday Shankar. That's where he had his company, Uday Shankar Company of Hindu Dancers and Musicians. It was the headquarters.
I feel so strongly attached to Paris because of my childhood connections. And Dada, of course, was the figurehead and the personality under whom we all developed in many ways. To me, Dada was like a hero. Anything he did was just great for me. Next to Gandhi and Tagore, his name was known all over Europe and United States and Canada. He was a pioneer in bringing Indian dance and music to the West. The whole setting of stage craftsmanship and showmanship, lighting, decor, costumes, never it has been done before him with such good taste. But he never took any ideas from Ballet Russe or Western thing. It was all basically Indian.
He was, and still is, I think, one of the greatest influences in my life. Because being in the troupe, I was constantly in the whole atmosphere of dance and music. I was a good dancer. And I was getting a lot of name because I even did a solo dance called Chitra Sena. That was a great success. And we wondered whether he would become ultimately a great dancer like his celebrated brother Uday Shankar. I couldn't take music as a principal thing till what happened that in year 35, Dada invited one of our greatest musicians, Baba Ustad Alau Din Khan, and who joined the group. And meeting him was one of the greatest events in my life because that was the greatest personality of music that I have known. And that's how I chose to take music as my career.
Sadaluddin Khan, Baba as I called him, was a combination of a guru and a father figure. We were leaving Bombay to go to Europe, and my mother had come that time to see us off. And it was very emotional. She took my hand and put it in his hand and told him that this boy's father has died just a few months ago. And I would like you to accept him as your son and look after him. And she was crying, and our boat left after that. That was the last time I saw her, because she died after a few months. So, you know, from that time, Baba took a great affection for him, for me. And much later, when I came to Maihar to learn from him, he was really very kind to me, because normally he had such violent temper. I remember he beat one tabla student once, and he was in hospital for 6 months. Anything that was near his hand, he would take a hammer or whatever, and he would... One day he took the sitar from one of the students and just put it on his head like that, and the tumba went on his head. It was so pathetic, and at the same time it was so frightening. But, you know, he was so kind to me. One day he only told me, you know, when I could pick up dildedadrarda, some difficult bowl combination with zamzama, and he said, go wear some churis. Your hands are so nazuk, like a girl. You cannot pick up this thing. Go and wear a churi. And that was enough for me. I felt so hurt. I went home and packed up my bedding and I wanted to leave. And then his son, Ali Akbar Sahib, came much later on and said, please don't do that. You are so lucky. I mean, imagine, I have been tied to a tree and beaten up for 3 days. In the beginning, it was very difficult for me, going from the glitter and glamour of Western life, hotels and best life possible, staying in a room. It took me a long time to get into that groove of life. And then, little by little, I started practicing for 8 hours and 12 hours, sometimes 14 to 16 hours. And this went on for years, really. In those days I was very enthusiastic and people sort of encouraged me to start schools. But after running it for a couple of years in Bombay and also in Los Angeles, I closed them, because I found that as far as I am concerned, I believe that our music is only possible to teach in the old Guru Parampara system. Of course, the schools are necessary, and there are many schools running in India. As the saying goes, that they don't create Tan sense, but they create Kan sense, which means they can help you to understand music or appreciate music. But it's really impossible to become a good musician by learning in a choir school. And this old Guru Parampara system, Gurukul system, is the best really, which means person to person. That's how our music, Shastra, Dharma, Yoga, everything has been passed down from the Guru to his Shishya. Days have changed and time has changed. Before, a Guru could keep 10, 12 students at home, feed them, and so that there was no problem about time. They would go on for years and years, you know, imbibe the music, not learn.
Yeah.
morning to evening be under the aura and that whole atmosphere of gurus, you know, it was not just music, but the way of life, which is very difficult today. I know. Concentrate on 2, 3, 4, maybe not more than that, and work very hard with them. Also, there's a problem, see, it should be, as the saying goes, the Aadhar, which means the correct type of student with the attitude, talent, hard working, and patience, which is very important. Unless one finds all this together, it's very hard to really teach. To have a research center sort of thing, especially here in Hemangana, where apart from having those few students that I told you about whom I could teach, I would like to have visiting musicians and musicologists, scholars, to create an atmosphere so that there could be discussions, and in general the atmosphere should be such that one can learn without sitting down to learn.
Thank you.
I find already a whole group of musicians who are almost the next age group than, say, myself or Ustad Ali Akbar Khan or Bismillah Khan. I mean the group who are the elderly group today. And the next group are really in very good shape and fine musicians. Next, and even the group after that, younger, there are very many promising musicians. The whole thing is that because the whole tradition has changed, and this is jet age and the speed and communication, it has affected quite a bit the new students, you know, because time element, they have less patience. They want to come out and perform much sooner than we ever thought of doing. That's the only drawback, but you know, as I said, I'm optimistic.
दादरा ठेका दिन दिन ना था तुम दिन दिन ना के ना तो तीरा की टक्का का तीरा की टक्का का Now I want you to say the same thing but once each, once of this each. For that you have to first say the last one, sir, like this. Three. Like that, then once, then double of it, ready.
This is Shubho, my son.
Well, Shubho plays sitar very, very well, but he didn't want to take it as a profession. He likes to take it as a hobby. And he's a painter. He's doing his commercial art master's in that in Los Angeles. And he has married there and settled down. I'm now a proud grandfather. This is Somu, my grandson, who's about 6 months old. Isn't it cute? I'll show you some other. The one I like very much is the great thinker. He's really something. Most of the time I like to relate with people I love or like very much. I really like to laugh, play games and things like that.
English?
Seven.
4207.
Fifth word.
Figures in a moment as Chandra bowls,
and that then is the wicket of Chandrasekhar, and India has won this match. Mohinder taking the catch of short square leg, and India has beaten New Zealand and beaten them convincingly. I'll give you the figures exactly. It is 162 runs, India's margin of victory. As you can see, the players jubilant, congratulating each other, and India has won this match by 162 runs.
I love to read, and I read almost anything from very serious things to very, very, simple things, very funny things.
Well, my reaction to the Bangladesh crisis was very spontaneous. I felt that something has to be done about it, especially for the refugees and the children. So I approached my student George Harrison, and he in turn approached some of his friends, and then we put up the show at the Madison Square Garden, and it was one of the greatest events that might have happened up to date. We raised a lot of money, and the record was a great success. It sold more than 1 million copies. Also, the documentary film which was made out of this show was a great success. UNICEF distributed the money wherever it was necessary, especially to the children, the city refugees. I have my father-in-law, as I call him, traveling with me most of the time. This Mr. Malik, Nodu Malik, actually he made this sitar. It's like his daughter, and he takes care of it, and he mostly travels with me. When I was young, I spent most of my time in the West. I saw that our music was appreciated in the sense that they've always said, including the musicians, that it was very exciting, very exotic. But they also said it is very repetitious and very monotonous. It goes on and on. Even those little slides mean that we pull, they sort of ridicule it as sound of a cat mewing, mew, mew, meow. And all these things used to make me furious. Even at that age, though I was not a musician, I just, had an aptitude for music, but I felt that they really don't know the greatness of our music. That's why, after being established for many, many years in my country, I felt that I must go to the West to make them understand the greatness of our music. For centuries in the West, you know, they are used to listening to a concert, not more than, say, 2 hours, 2 hours, 15 minutes, or 2.5 hours at the most. Therefore, I knew that if I went and started Raag Darbari Kanada Alap or Malkhon Alap for 1.5 hours, it will be difficult for people who have never heard our music before. All that, I just started with shorter numbers. I really was inspired more from South India, because in the Carnatic music, they always start, as you know, with shorter items. Since last couple of years, I have stopped even doing that. I mean, playing short items. Now I'm performing exactly almost as I would do in Bombay or Calcutta. Thank you.
has always been a controversy in the sense that because of my two separate identities or personalities, musically I mean, one as a sitar player, where I'm very traditional, very orthodox, I really want to follow, and I do follow the Binkar Gharana, which is directly from Tansen, and I was lucky in getting the proper talim or training from Baba. But the other is as a composer, and that's where I'm not frightened ever to experiment anything that comes to my mind. Most of these songs that I've tuned are my own lyrics, especially in Hindi and Bengali. I have even tried my hand in English. I'm Missing You, Krishna, Where Are You, that's just written by me, which has become quite a hit song. Association with George has meant a great deal in my cutting two albums, Shankar Family and Friends and Festival from India. He helped in the production of his records. George's extreme love and desire for Indian music inspired me in making these albums. All the words that were sung, whether it was in classical form or in Tarana form or anything.
I remember that you recollect that Thumri which you wrote, I think, for the first time when you went.
Supne Mein Aaye.
Will you sort of hum it for us?
That was which my sister-in-law Lakshmi Shankar sang. Supne Mein Aaye. Pritam Sanyap Supane Mein Aaye
Supane Mein Aaye Pritam Sanyap Supane Mein
sitar concerto, for instance. That was a very great challenge for me because this has never been attempted. this was conducted by a very famous Andre Previn, who is the chief conductor of the London Symphony Orchestra. Treated the orchestra more or less as an extension of sitar. Can use the dynamics, the whole range of symphony orchestra.
धमकासू के बाद ओके धमकासू के बाद थोड़ा सा पॉज दीजिए, तानपुरा चलता रहे।
घुंगरिया धमकासू राणा जी गोविंद के गुण गासू।
काम करो चलता है तो दसी कौन फेल हो गया। हाँ एक दफे सुन लीजिए पूरा इसका मिजाज देख लीजिए यही साज है इतनी माइनस मी एवरीथिंग इज
दो टेक में होगा ये।
हाँ एक चीज सुन लिया दोनों से एक रुक जाता है एक पोर्शन में और दूसरा कंटिन्यू करता है जस्ट हियर बोथ ऑफ देम स्टार्ट विद वॉइस अलोन क्वाइट एकदम सूप सुना दो
राणा जी मैं तो गोविंद के गुण गासूं राजा रूठी नगरी आखे हरी रूठा कहाँ जासूं राणा जी मैं तो गोविंद के गुण गासूं हरि मन
I think the old spiritual and mysticism and music is very interlinked. Like the very old Hindus, I believe that there's a meeting place between sensuality and spirituality.